Want to learn how to calculate percentages with pivot tables? Get ready because today I'm walking you through it step by step. By the end of this video, you'll be a pivot table pro, clearly showing what percentage of the total your data represents. Let's dive in. Imagine you work at Tesla, and none other than Elon Musk, your boss, comes up with a special request. This year, Elon's all in on boosting Cybertruck sales. It's been the main mission for the sales team, and while some have shined, others have lagged behind. With this document detailing sales by dealership and by sales rep, Elon has two tasks for you. First, figure out which dealership led in Cybertruck sales and will win a shiny new Model S as a prize. Yeah! The second task is more dramatic. You need to identify all the salespeople who didn't follow orders to the letter and whose Cybertruck sales don't exceed 20% of their total sales. And for them, the news is tough. They'll be fired today. We could tackle these tasks with multiple SUMMIT functions, but if I were you, I wouldn't risk getting fired by Elon for being slow with Excel. So how about we solve it in a couple of minutes using pivot tables? First, select any part of your database. Then head to the Insert tab and choose Pivot Table. Excel will ask for two important things. First is the data range to use for the table. While Excel is pretty good at auto-selecting your data, it's always wise to double-check. The second is where you want the pivot table to be set up. Let's opt to place it on a new sheet. Once on this new sheet, you'll see a section on the right with all the fields from our original database. To create the pivot table, simply drag the fields to the correct spots. Elon wants to know which dealership led in Cybertruck sales, right? Start by determining the units sold by each dealership. Just drag the dealership field to the rows and the units sold field to the values. And voila. Now, to see the breakdown by model, simply add the model's field to the columns, and there you have it. But we're not done yet. For those percentages we need to calculate, follow these simple steps. Add the units sold again to the values area, which will create a new column with exactly the same values. Then, right-click on any cell in that new column, select Show Values As, and then choose Percentage of Column Total. And just like that, bam! Now you have the percentage of units sold by each dealership right in front of your eyes. You might be wondering, why do I have to select percentage of column total and not one of the other available options? Good question, kiddo. By opting to show the percentages of the total by column, and since the columns represent the models, these numbers tell us what percentage of the total units sold of each model was contributed by each dealership. For example, Austin accounted for 16% of the Cybertruck sales, Boston for 15%, and so forth. If we chose percentage of row total, since the rows represent the dealerships, it would show what percentage of the total units sold by each dealership corresponds to each model. So, from the total cars sold by the dealership in Austin, 19% were Cybertrucks, another 19% were Model 3s, and so on. But since Elon asked for the percentages in relation to the total of each model, let's stick with that. But before these data get to Musk, we need to give them a bit of aesthetic TLC. You know, after all the effort you've put into this analysis, we don't want a sloppy presentation to be the reason you get the boot. Let's start by cleaning up those field names that look like they were pulled from a sewer. Sum of units sold and sum of units sold to are just atrocious. It's simple. We'll rename them directly in the header to units sold and percent of units sold. Clear and to the point. Now, a little confession on my part, it might just be my OCD talking, but do we really need two decimals in our percentages? If we drop them, our table won't only look cleaner, but also more professional. Right-click on any cell in that column, select number format, and under the percentages section, adjust to zero decimals. Perfect! Let's keep removing distractions. We agreed that Elon wants to see percentages relative to the total for each model, right? So, those totals at the bottom are useful, but the ones in the right column are just a distraction since dealership totals aren't helpful to us. Let's get rid of them. With your table selected, go to the Design tab and under the Grand Totals option, choose On for Columns Only. That'll make the unwanted totals on the right disappear. While we're at it, why not add some style? In this same tab, you can choose one of the preset designs for pivot tables. Sadly, there's no Tesla red style, but the one we've got here will do the trick. For the final touch, go to the Pivot Table Analyze tab and click on the Field Headers button to turn off the headers. Look at that change! With these tweaks, we're more than ready to show Elon what he asked for. We can clearly see that the Seattle dealership contributed the most to the Cybertruck sales, with 30% of the total. Now, let's move on to the second task, identifying the salespeople who will be fired because the Cybertruck represents less than 20% of their total sales. First, we need to tweak our pivot table. We don't need to see the dealerships anymore, right? We want to see the data at the sales rep level, so let's change that. Remove the dealership field and then add the sales reps to the rows. Regarding the models, we currently have them in the columns. But I think in this case, it makes sense to put the breakdown in rows underneath each rep for easier understanding. There, better, right? But if you pay attention, these numbers don't tell us much because they show percentages relative to the general total of units sold. That is, Alice's Cybertruck sales represent 1% of the total, her Model 3 sales, 1% of the total, and so forth. What Elon asked us is to show percentages relative to the total of each sales rep, right? Let's make it happen. Right-click, go to Show Values As, and then choose More Options. In the new window, if you select Show Data As, you'll see all the options Excel offers. What we need now is percentage of parent total. What's this parent thing? Simple, when you make breakdowns, a parent field is simply the field that's higher up in the hierarchy. In our case, we can say that the child field are the models, and the parent field is the reps. Finally, just tell Excel which parent field you want to base it on. Here, it's the sales rep. Click OK and done. Now we can show Elon that, for example, Alice and Benjamin will be fired today. Feeling guilty for helping Musk fire dozens of people? Earn some good karma points by becoming a pivot table guru with this mini course here. Okay, I'll be honest, in this course we're going to end up firing Tesla's CFO. So don't do it for karma, just because it will be fun.